So here's the backstory. My name is Monal and my husband name is Prateek, and we are an Indian couple who came for our honeymoon in Maldives from India. So we planned it for 26th March to 29th March 2021. It was supposed to be a short vacation for us. How you plan is that you have to get the RT-PCR test done. So we got our RT-PCR test done on 24th March, since we had a flight on 26th and we got tested negative there. Then on 27th, we got another test, RT-PCR test, because we had to fly back from Malé to Delhi. So you have to get a test in Maldives as well. So we got tested, and then today I got my report. Today morning, I tested positive and my husband was tested negative, which was weird because I literally had no symptoms. That's the backstory. Now coming to what happens next. So number one, now they plan to send us to quarantine center. There are some government quarantine center. The couple cannot stay together because one is tested positive, another one is negative. So I will be going to the government treatment center while my husband will be transferred to the government isolation center, which is on the same island. It's on the mainland. We asked the resort people if we could stay over here, but unfortunately they cannot guarantee any health facility if it's needed, although we hardly doubt that we would need it, but the resort people would not risk it, and I think that's fair on their part. They've been very helpful. So by today, the entire day we were waiting for the confirmation from Maldives Embassy, Maldives Health Center, or whatever you call that. So, and then the health government need to issue some sort of form or some confirmation that there is availability and we could be moved. So we were waiting for the entire day, but they have not got any confirmation from them yet. So we most probably will be shifted tomorrow to the center. At the time, there are a lot of questions. You're worried, how will be the center? Will we be not able to see each other for next 14 days? And we'll be in different facilities. We'll not be able to, we're worried about the facility, how the facility would be, and a lot of questions which are still unanswered. So worried and fingers crossed. I don't know what's gonna happen tomorrow. Quick update from today. Okay, there is one important thing which I want to highlight. Things that you should not do when in Malé. So last week I purchased a new phone. I bought a Samsung S21. I thought I'll be clicking a lot of good pictures in daytime and the night time. It has a good night picture quality. So I bought a new Samsung S21 recently, only for this particular trip. We were excited about this one. It's supposed to be my dream vacations, unfortunately. But so there's one thing which you should never do. So 27th, I turned on the data service. I wanted to receive an OTP for one of my login credentials, and I turned on the mobile data. The minute I did that, I don't know, with Samsung S21, they have introduced some sort of security feature, I would say, that if your phone is turned on with the network into a different country, they lock your phone. And they ask for a password. Now, funny thing, I never entered a password. I just set a fingerprint scanner and I set a pattern lock. So two locks were there, but it's not asking me any of it. And it's just asking me to enter a password, which was never set. We tried on FMM, that is find my, F, they call it FMP or FMM. It's Find My Phone service on Samsung. So we went there, where you can try to unlock it remotely. We tried that. It fails because they say my phone, in my settings, it's not enabled. We called Samsung Care Center. We've been calling Samsung Care Center for last 2 days. Me, my husband, my brother, everyone have tried every way of reaching Samsung India. Over emails, over calls. We've also tried Samsung customer care centers in Malé, but real hard luck. They keep on pushing it to the carrier. We've talked to the carrier, that is Airtel. No luck there. Very, very disappointed. Very disappointed with that. But yeah, the news. So I was stuck here for my day one. I didn't have a phone. I didn't have any connectivity with my husband or anyone for that matter. I just had a phone to the reception where I used to ask for my lunch, dinner, breakfast, and that was the entire connectivity which I had. We did ask the resort people to help us with the phone, and they are really helpful. We are staying at Thulagiri and they helped us bought this new phone. It's a Redmi N9i. So I just asked for a smartphone where I can have some WhatsApp calling, because that all I wanted. So yeah, so they gave us this Redmi N9i phone. I can't show you the phone because that's the one which I'm using for the video at the moment. But yeah, so lesson learned: when in different country, don't turn on your data service before asking your carrier. I think that's, and honestly, I'm so disappointed. I moved from Apple to Samsung, but I'm so disappointed. Even if they had this security feature, I appreciate that, but they should have their personal strained on that. The customer care center should know what is the unlock password, how do we do that. And if I have not set a password, it's a major bug in Samsung's phone if they are asking for a password. I mean, this is really weird and funny at the same time. But yeah, pathetic. I wish I could just go back and give it back to them. But yeah, that's the update for today. Tomorrow we'll be shifted to the government facility, hopefully, if we get the letter from the embassy. So I'll keep you posted how it goes. Bye.